Hey there, Manna Church. Time for another morning manna. And I want to talk to you about a king named Rehoboam. We're talking about 12 lessons from 12 kings. And I think Rehoboam is one of the hardest spots he can be. Rehoboam is the son of Solomon. And he takes over Israel when Israel and Judah are unified. He's the last king to lead unified Israel and Judah. And he's in a tough spot. His dad was Solomon, who's the wisest man to ever walk the planet. And here's Rehoboam trying to lead a people. And so he finds himself very quickly in a very tough circumstance. The people come to him and they're asking for help. And so Rehoboam, he's not as wise as his father. And the smartest thing he could do is surround himself with the right people, but he hasn't. Let's take a look at Rehoboam in 2 Chronicles chapter 10. The people come to him and say, "Your father made our yoke heavy. Now therefore, lighten the hard service of your father and his heavy yoke on us, and we will serve you." He said to them, "Come to me in 3 days." So the people went away. And then he takes counsel. He takes, as it says here in verse 6, he takes the counsel of the old men who were the advisors of Solomon. And he says, "What should I do?" And fundamentally they say, "Look, your father was hard, lighten the load." He takes the counsel of the young men and he says, "What should I do?" And they're like, "Listen, dude, you gotta make your stand. You gotta stamp this. Tell them that my pinky is thicker than my father's thigh. If my father was hard on you, I'll be harder." Rehoboam makes the fundamental mistake. What he should have done, he should have listened to the wise guys, the older guys. What does he do? He listens to the young men. So when the people come back and say, "What do you have to tell us?" He says, "My pinky is thicker than my father's thigh." And they say, "Okay, you're gonna be hard on us? Forget you." And 10 tribes leave him and he's stuck with Judah. See, I think that's an important lesson for all of us. We need to be people who are careful about those who pour into our lives and invest in us. Take a look at your circle, because your circle is a mirror. If you look at the people closest to you, it shows you who you are and where you are. Let's make sure the people around us, the people who are closest to us, the people who are helping us move forward, are people who are going to help us walk closer to God, not step into huge mistakes. I think that's important for every single one of us. God bless you, Manna Church. I hope you have a tremendous day.